Get ready to meet Homaro Cantu. He's the futuristic chef behind two of Chicago's hottest restaurants. An international leader in molecular gastronomy, he is equal parts artist and mad scientist. Using science and technology, he is challenging the very definition of what is and what isn't food. And over the next half hour, you'll see how the mind-bending dishes that he's serving today could change the way that you eat tomorrow.
My name is Homaro Cantu, and I'm a molecular gastronomist. I own Moto, Ing, and Cantu Designs in Chicago. A molecular gastronomist is really just someone who explores the world of science and food. We're always playing with your expectations as to what this food could be. We use a lot of different tools, centrifuges, sonifiers, lasers. We're actually starting to work with some superconductors. If you look at, you know, the limitations of creating new products, you're only limited by the technology that you have to work with. You know, the real thrill with the food experiments that we do is creating something that's impossible, creating something that just shouldn't be. I built a lab in my restaurant because we really wanted to take experimentation to the next level and just bring it right in front of the guests. So we have, you know, three moving parts here. We have Cantu Designs, which is really the hub of innovation. We can implement those ideas at Moto Restaurant and then see if they're more applicable to the mainstream at Ing Restaurant, which tends to be a much more fast casual establishment. Well, what's very different about Moto and Ing, you know, as opposed to other restaurants in similar price categories, is we're always looking for a bigger idea. You know, we don't want to make just, you know, crazy food to be crazy. For example, we serve an edible menu here. We have almost since day one. And that's because serving edible menus makes a lot of sense. Every month, about 20 tons of paper are wasted in restaurant menus alone. And so, you know, by that rationale, if you just ate your menu and it was made from organic local products, you could eliminate that paper waste. It looks like a sushi roll, it tastes like a sushi roll, but it's your menu. We just have to always be putting ourselves in a position of taking a bigger risk, because our customers, they expect that. They want to see something really new. You know, they're looking for their hair to be blown back 10 ways, and that's a very big challenge. We like to do a fun thing with what we define seasonal products to be. Here we have a biosphere, and we have some seafood products that are gonna go in that biosphere. So here we have some sea beans, we have some saltine crackers, we have a cushy oyster, which definitely has a nice brininess to it, a little bit of crab meat. Next we have sea foam, so that's sort of reminiscent of going to the ocean. And then finally, we have some smoked apple puree. Next thing we're gonna do is take this biosphere and we're gonna place it right onto that apple puree to form a watertight seal. We're gonna take this gas right here, which is 9 times heavier than air, which is gonna enable us to pull off this trick of creating a weather system within this biosphere. It's really cool to watch. Then at the table, we basically pull that off, and then this inner gas starts falling. And then the smoke just sort of, you know, goes right over the food. We clear this, and then the diner just starts shoveling stuff in their mouth. It's really tasty. And that's our seafood biosphere. You know, I like to compare what we do to, like, the iPhone. A tremendous amount of engineering and thought goes into that product. But when you see it at the table, you're not really thinking about that. This food just sort of works. Stressful part that I put pressure on my staff is, what are we going to create today? And then how is it going to become a bigger player in the global picture? I was really into junk food as a kid. You know, we ate a lot of McDonald's and Burger King and things like that. Nothing healthy. That's why I'm so fascinated with people who want to eat junk food. You know, I want to eat junk food. My kids love junk food. So we want to give them what they want. Replicating all that junk food out of health food is really where the future in food lies. And then, you know, hopefully we'll see that on aisle, you know, 2, 4, and 6 at the grocery store, where all of that bad food that you used to, you know, feel guilty about eating is actually good for you. The big goal here is to redefine what we have at the grocery store level. I think that what we do in restaurants is great. It's fun. It's exciting. We get to test it out on our guests. But if we could take that to the next level, maybe in a school lunch program, or maybe in a homeless shelter, or, you know, just somewhere else, I think that would be a huge win.